Our Lord Jesus Christ does not want us to be in dark when he said to the disciples, I send you out as sheep in the midst of wolves. Matthew chapter 10 verse 16. And in Luke chapter 10 verse 3, he repeated that same word when he said, I send you out as lambs in the midst of wolves. There are wolves in this world. Two types of people. The lambs or the sheep and the wolves. Good morning. You are welcome to I Prevail with Joseph Adenuga. As usual, the God of the universe, your Father, my Father, the God of all flesh who love you with an everlasting love, have sent me again to you this morning to encourage you, to motivate you, to inspire you, and to bless you. And this morning, as you hear this word, may the Lord take you from glory to glory. May the Lord empower you and help you to see the enormous power that lies on the inside of you. May you receive wisdom to know what to do with this great gigantic power that is sleeping on the inside of you. May you arise and shine in the mighty name of Jesus. May you arise and know what to do. May you tread upon your dangerous enemies. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Amen. You see, the reason why God wants me to send these messages to you every day is just to remind you, we are living in a world that it is very easy for us to forget. We are human beings. We forget. We relapse. You see, many times we don't, you know, when we come out of an experience, after some time we forget. You can see that in the people of Israel. That's how people are. They left Egypt. They saw signs and wonders. They crossed the Red Sea to the other side. And in only 3 days, they began to cry, and because there was no water. And they began to see dangerous things that you will be surprised that those who just saw a great miracle of their lives are talking like this. They were saying, is it because there was no grave in Egypt you have brought us to this wilderness to die of thirst? In only a few days, they forgot. And that is why we need to keep reminding ourselves. And that is why God raised up some of us to speak this word to you every day. And as many as are willing to hear will be remembered. You will be reminded of the word of God that will keep you stable and anchor your soul in the refuge of God. And today I want you to understand there are two types of human beings. There are predators and prey. Predators, when you look at the wild animals on TV, you're going to see predators are those animals that are out to kill and to eat other animals. That's the way of life. That's what they do to survive. They eat other animals. And prey are those animals that must be eaten by the predators. And so Jesus Christ, our Lord, in the book of Matthew chapter 10 verse 16, is telling us a very important fact. That even among human beings, there are predators. And that is why he said to the disciples, I send you out as sheep in the midst of wolves. In Luke chapter 10 verse 3, he said, I send you out as lambs. You know, lambs are so gentle. He said, I send you out as lambs in the midst of lions, in the midst of wolves. It is very, very difficult for a lamb to succeed in the midst of wolves. And that is why Jesus Christ, our Lord, gave us, he said, be therefore wise. Be ye therefore wise as serpent. And be innocent as doves. This is the way out. When you know that you are a prey, or you may be a prey, or you are a lamb in the midst of wolves, you must be wise. Because you see, the wolves are just moving around, seeking whom they will destroy. And that is what 1 Peter chapter 5 verse 8 was reiterating when he says, be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, is walking about, is looking for whom he may devour. Because he knows we are lambs, we are sheep, and we are surrounded by wolves. We need to be smart. We need to be wise. That is why Jesus said, be wise as serpent. Be innocent as doves. You see, you need to be wise, because if you are not wise, the wolves of life, the lions of life, the predators of life, some of them are predators. They are in the human body. They are predators in human flesh. They are devil incarnate. They are out to destroy, to kill, to steal, and to destroy. This is what the Bible says. He said, but I have come that they might have life and that they might have it abundantly. In everything you do today, God is saying, be wise. In your dealings with people, God is saying, be wise. In your interaction with others, God is saying, be innocent as doves. You see, doves are so innocent. He said, be innocent as doves. This is the recommendation of our Lord Jesus Christ. This is the way out to escape the predators. This is the way out to escape those people who are out to eat up us alive. You remember, the Bible says, if it has not been the Lord that was on our side, then the enemy will have tear us and eaten us up alive. And for us to escape them, we need to be wise. Wisdom is the key word today. And that is why the prayer is, Lord, fill me with wisdom. Lord, teach me to know what to do in every situation. Give me the wisdom to see men who they really are. Lord, give me the discerning spirit to discern the intentions of men. There are some people, they come, their intention is hidden. They put forth another intention. You think their intention is to help you. You think their intention is to look after you and, be a big brother or a sister who will take care of you. But their hidden intention, they have a hidden agenda. The agenda is really to kill, to steal, and to destroy. So, but when you pray for the discerning of spirits, God will help you to know those who came, those who are lions in sheep's clothing. There are so many lions in sheep's clothing in every area of life, in business, in relationship, even in the family, they are lions in sheep's clothing. When they come to you, they look gentle, but deep inside them is that predator. You need to be wise. You need to pray. Lord, help me not to fall. That's why Jesus said, when he taught us how to pray, he said, and lead us not into temptation. So you need to pray, Lord. And another thing, you need to be innocent, meaning don't be a predator yourself, meaning don't be a lion in sheep scolding yourself. Many people, they want safety, but they are bringing danger to other people's lives. Don't do that. Be innocent as doves. Because Jesus knows that what you sow is what you will reap. That is why he's saying, be wise as serpent, but be innocent as doves. Don't be among those who are planning the downfall of other people. Don't be among those who are happy when other people fall. Don't be among those who set other people up so that they can be set up and fail and fall so that you can broadcast their failure. Don't be like that. Don't be a predator. And when you take the recommendation of our Lord Jesus Christ and you pray and you become as wise as serpents and as innocent as doves, there is no wolf of life that will take you. That is why the Bible says the Lord will give his angels charge over you and they will keep you in their hands lest you dash your foot against a stone. He said, the angels of the Lord encamped round about them that fear him and delivereth them. There are wolves, there are predators, but you are surrounded by angels. There are wolves, there are predators, there are lions of life, but the angels of God keep you in their hands. This is what you must remember. And this is the word this morning. Thank you for listening. May God bless you. Take you from where you are to where you desire to be, in Jesus' name. Thank you. You are able to receive this because of the partners of I Prevail. God bless you. partners in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you once again. It is well with your soul. Please rebroadcast this to somebody. Get somebody blessed. And if you love this and you want it on WhatsApp on a daily basis, just save this number +27 74 03 02 381. Save it right now with I Prevail. Go to your WhatsApp. Just send me this message. Add me. And from tomorrow, you receive this. Thank you so much. It is well with your soul, your brother, your friend, your pastor, Joseph Adenuga, signing out this morning and saying to you, be blessed and remain blessed.